Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Santa Barbara Nutrients YouTube channel. Today, we have Diana Bruen with us. So Diana is a registered dietitian and a renal nutrition expert. She's the founder of the PKD Dietitian, where she provides nutrition therapy and education to patients with CKD and PKD. And Diana received her master's degree in nutrition and health promotion from Simmons College and has been a dietitian for over 14 years. So she has a lot of expertise in this area. Diana focuses on proactive nutrition for PKD and kidney health. So her research interests include plant-focused ketogenic therapies, pain modification through dietary intervention, and a plant-based diet for chronic kidney disease and polycystic kidney disease. Diana also runs the PKD Nutrition Academy, which is a learning hub for all things PKD and nutrition related. Her vision is to bring science-based nutrition and education for PKD community on a wider scale with easier access for all. So some of you might recognize Diana from the Renew program. So she was actually one of the lead program facilitators of the Renew program in the very beginning of the development. For those of you who don't know, the Renew program is a plant-based, low-oxalate nutrition program for people with polycystic kidney disease, and it was developed by polycystic kidney disease researchers and renal nutrition experts. And Diana is also part of the Santa Barbara Nutrients team, so we're very lucky to have her on our team. Today, Diana will be talking about potassium and kidney disease and what that really means. Diana, welcome. Thank you so much for joining us today. Diana will start us off on the topic of potassium and kidney disease. So we'll jump in, Diana, and welcome again. If you can go ahead and just, what is potassium?
Hey, everybody. I'm excited to be here talking about some important topics. So what is potassium? Potassium is actually a mineral, and it's something that we call an essential mineral, and it's considered essential basically because our bodies cannot make it. And that translates to we have to get it from our food. And every single tissue in your body needs potassium, so clearly pretty important. And you might hear potassium referred to as an electrolyte. Well, an electrolyte is simply a mineral that's circulating in your body, and it has a little bit of charge. Now, potassium has a little positive charge in your body, and that's actually a really good thing. And looking at the overview of your body, most of the potassium is actually in your cells. So the amount of potassium that is in your blood, like when you get some test looking at your kidney function and your kidney panel, they're looking at potassium, that is a very little amount. About 98% is actually in your cells. And it's super important for lots of different functions in your body, and it's a very positive thing, total pun intended. So just to kind of flesh out some of that, why is potassium important? Here's just some of the things in your body that that mineral electrolyte is involved in. It helps to regulate fluid balance. It's also connected with how your nerve signals and functions. Super important in your muscles and the contractions. In fact, in your body, and I like numbers, so you're going to get some numbers, 80% of that potassium in your cells is in your muscles. And guess what? Your heart is a muscle. So potassium, super important for how your heart beats. And it helps to regulate blood pressure. And one of the coolest things about potassium in your body, remember it's coming from your diet, is that potassium actually, with that positive charge, helps to move nutrients into your cells, absolutely a good thing, and move waste out of your cells. So that balance, super important.
Very fascinating. I think that, you know, potassium kind of gets overlooked a lot, right? And I don't think that individuals really realize how much of an impact that it has and how much it's actually needed by multiple different functions in the body. So if we tie that maybe back to kidney disease, right? So I know you're an expert in that. A lot of people hear, you know, that potassium, they might have to limit that if they have kidney disease. Can you talk briefly about that relationship and why that might occur?
Absolutely. Such a good question, because too frequently I hear people say, oh, I stopped eating anything with potassium in it. I'm protecting my kidneys. You know, as soon as I learn that I have, you know, some impaired kidney function, I'm going to stop eating it, protect my kidneys. Guess what? That's an absolute myth. So I want to break down a little bit about the kidneys and potassium. Potassium actually has no effect on the kidneys. I'm gonna pause there so you guys can process that. What the kidneys actually do is they filter potassium. So the kidneys are super important for balancing the potassium in your body. They really are the boss of it. So if your body, those cells needs more potassium, the kidneys will hold on to some potassium and send it their way. If you have excess potassium, the kidneys will filter it out and you'll get rid of it when you urinate. So they really are the balance keeper in the potassium balance. And too much or too little is not necessarily going to impact your kidney health. Now, however, with kidney function that is less than desirable for you, if you have a decreased function, that lower GFR, there is a chance that your kidneys won't filter that potassium as well as they need to. So that's why we hear potassium and kidneys connected. Because if the kidneys aren't keeping that balance in your body or filtering the potassium in your blood as well as they need to, that is when you may see higher numbers in your labs. They call it hyperkalemia, but that is when you have higher potassium in your blood. Now, we're talking about the kidneys, but I want to take it one step back and also mention the heart. And why? Because the heart is what is impacted by potassium. So your heart, and like I said, uses potassium to contract. The danger of having too much potassium is, or even too low potassium in your blood, is that that beat and that rhythm of your heart contractions could be altered. And that's why we hear about dangers of high potassium.
Okay. Wow. Great explanation on that. I think that there's a lot of misunderstanding, right? And we think about, oh, you know, I have high blood potassium, right? And I must limit that for my kidneys. But I really like how you broke that down and explained the difference between kind of, you know, the kidneys are there to help with the filtration of that. And so that might be the reason behind why somebody might need to be limiting that, right? And if we're talking about specifically kidney disease and potassium, do you think that, you know, individuals who are told to limit their potassium intake, that's merely due to the reasoning behind maybe their GFR or the stage that they are in for kidney disease? Does that kind of tie together if they are told by, you know, a practitioner, you need to watch your potassium intake? Is it because of that hyperkalemia?
Another good question. So I think the important part of that question is if you are told that you need to limit your potassium intake. So the situations where you would be told that is if your healthcare provider is seeing your lab values higher than where they want it to be. Now, this doesn't happen to everybody with kidney disease. I've worked with many people who have had lower function and no issues with potassium. And so it really is based on what's going on with each person and their labs. What is very important to know is that only restrict potassium if your doctor has told you to. And I'll get back to why in a minute, but we actually changed the guidelines recently that are recommended for kidney disease and potassium. And finally, the recommendations caught up with what we know. And the recommendation is there is no limit on potassium unless your blood level is above normal. So that's really important. You do not want to limit those potassium-rich foods unless your blood value is above normal and your doctor has told you that you would benefit from limiting your foods. And that's not for your kidney health, that's for your heart health. And so if your doctor tells you that, there are a couple things that I would highly recommend walking through with your doctor. And the first is to say, to go over your potassium trends, because trends is key. You know, you want to talk with your doctor about, was this a one-off? What have my trends been showing? And go over that, because your trends are more important than one situation. And the second thing I would ask your doctor is there a non-dietary reason why my potassium could be high? Because guess what? It's not always the diet, although diet is always blamed. Just some examples, there are medications that can make your potassium go high. You could have chronic constipation and have high potassium. You know, you could have an infection or higher blood sugar. So there are lots of different things that can affect your potassium. So you definitely want to look at those with your doctor. Of note, with polycystic kidney disease, a lot of the medications that are used to help control blood pressure do cause your body to hold on to potassium. So it is absolutely worth looking at your blood pressure medications there. So that's the second thing. Absolutely say, are there non-dietary causes? And then the third thing I would ask is, what is my recommended restriction? Because if someone tells you you need to restrict, well, what is the recommended intake that I should restrict to? And then after that, absolutely important is to ask, where can I get help with doing this? I recommend absolutely getting a referral to a dietitian, because what you'll find is that a lot of folks that are restricting potassium because they've been told their doctor swing too far on the side of over restrict, and they're losing out on a lot of nutritious benefit, and they're really reducing the foods that they like to eat that they're eating. So absolutely work with a professional, find out what looks good for you. And then the two last things are, what is the plan to follow up and check my labs or monitor my intake or how my dietary changes are helping? And then also, what is my goal range? Because your potassium goal range can actually change based on your kidney function. So some really good things to walk through with your doctor. And you can go in with a plan and those lists and have a really good conversation and find out why and how.
Wow. That was very thorough, Diana. That was great advice. And that was actually one of my last questions, was kind of, you know, if an individual, you know, is told to limit their potassium intake, what steps do they need to take, right? And I really, really liked how you talked about the non-dietary causes of why potassium levels could be high. You know, a lot of times if sodium is high, potassium's high, any different type of, you know, vitamin, mineral, electrolytes, whatever that is, if it's high, like you said, right, diet is always what is kind of attributed to that, right? And I think that it's very, very insightful for you to say, speak to a renal dietitian or a dietitian in general, right? To help better understand this and then kind of dive into other ideas with your practitioner, right? Why might this be high? And so you talked about some medications. I think that's very important because with various disease states, a lot of medications can have underlying, you know, kind of an impact for these values to be high. So that was very, very thorough. And I appreciate you taking all of those steps to kind of talk somebody through what they should do if they're told that their potassium level is high. But I think this might apply to other, you know, lab values as well, right? And so kind of digging in a little bit deeper behind the reasoning and then focusing on how can I adjust this, right? Is it something I'm eating? Is it medication based? What are the steps I can take from here?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Perfect. Thank you, Diana.
Sure. And I want to step it back just a second, because when we're talking about kidneys and potassium, a lot out there is food fear. And a lot out there is doing, saying, I don't want to hurt my kidneys. I don't want to cause problems. But I really want to highlight some of the positives of potassium, because that's important to know too. So with overall health and even kidney health, here are the potassium positives. So we know that a diet that is high in rich potassium foods actually can help to relax your blood vessels. And it actually helps you. Potassium helps you. Remember when I said it pulls waste out? It helps for you to get rid of sodium. The overall effect there of the high potassium, lower sodium is better blood pressure management. So absolutely can help with that. And also, a higher intake of potassium-rich food is absolutely associated with lower heart disease. It's associated with lower kidney stone risk. And it's also associated with better outcomes with PKD. So I think switching that mindset from, do I need to restrict potassium? Right. And the answer is generally no. And if you don't, it's more a question of, how do I get more potassium in my diet? You know, the actual recommendation for potassium intake has been increased lately. It's 4,700 milligrams, wow. Which, you know, and I actually have tried to eat that much in a day. It takes a little bit of work, you know, it really does. But the cool part is we show all those positive benefits at around 3,500 milligrams a day. And I know I'm talking numbers here, but the average American diet has less than 3,000 milligrams a day. And wow. That actually is considered a potassium restriction. So just some of the really positive things about potassium.
Yeah, I like how you put that into perspective. And I also like how you're giving numbers, right? Sometimes numbers can be confusing, but I think that helps to quantify it. And from, you know, what I understand is a lot of people, just based on what they're eating day to day, aren't getting enough potassium, right? And so it seems like the only reason that you would want to, you know, restrict or decrease your intake is if you are specifically told by your practitioner. And that kind of goes back to more along the lines of the heart, right? As to why you need to restrict as opposed to the kidney health. So I think that there are a lot of almost myths you've kind of been busting here as well, Diana. And I appreciate you putting this into perspective for people, because, you know, if you do have a disease state, or if you have polycystic kidney disease in general, you hear so much out on the internet about you have to restrict your potassium, right? But it seems as though that might be doing more damage, you know, if you're not supposed to, as opposed to just actually trying to get enough in your own diet.
100%. Couldn't have said it better.
Perfect. Great. This has been super insightful, Diana. Really appreciate your time on here. And we will have multiple different links down at the bottom of this video. And one will be leading to Diana to kind of explain a little bit more about her background as well. So thank you again, Diana. Really appreciate your expertise on this topic.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye.